fun now. I'm going to change it up. No, I'm not going to defreeze because, you know, it's pretty good. Mix it up a little bit. We're going to do press conference.
Oh, man! Oh! Oh! Oh, I can't believe you went right to press conference, you asshole.
Sure.
All right. So, we're going to play a game called press conference. You may have heard that in the news. Press conference is a guessing game, and the shining ranger there is someone really, really famous, and he's going to give a talk, and the rest of us are going to disperse amongst the audience, and we are going to be from various newspapers and media outlets, because newspapers basically don't exist anymore. It's sad. That the journalism is sad. So anyway, I hope no one here studied that. So what I need from you is something that the Shiny Ranger accomplished, an achievement that he had. It could be the most of something, or it could be in an unusual location, or some combination of both.
Biggest poop.
Okay. I sense a trend in our audience and their interest areas. I don't even want to look at your browsing history. Okay, so did he make the biggest poop? Did he find the biggest poop? What happened?
He made it.
He made the biggest poop. Okay. And where did he do this soiling deed?
Five Guys.
I like it. Okay, it's gross. And remember, your suggestion and your voice will be on the internet forever.
That's
where it should be, right? Okay, let's welcome them in.
Oh, honor, yes. I know you're excited, and I'm excited too. Today, we will talk about my exploits. Let's begin. Yes, you, sir.
Yeah, Hank Inches from Metric Magazine. Do you really think size matters?
Well, if you think about it metrically, then... Well, it's really a question of what she prefers, but it definitely does. Mm. It definitely matters.
Thank you.
Yes. Man with the sim IQ face, you.
Yes! I'm a guy, but that's okay. We'll talk later. I'm Teddy from Turtlehead Magazine, and I was wondering, did you have to save up for a while, or did it just come right up?
Well... You know, when all of this happened, and I mean all of it, it was a surprise. But I was sort of aware that it was going to happen, but it was a surprise for me. So, to answer your question, I did not. You and life.
It's me, Mario, from Plumbers Weekly. Did you have any problem disposing of it afterwards?
When my controller vibrated inside of my pants, I kept it because we had a connection afterwards. Sir,
yes.
You.
Xavier Lax from Pharmaceutical Journal. And we are dying to know whether there were any artificial aids used in this, or was this a completely natural phenomenon?
Well, everything aids everyone, you know? Like, a waitress can aid you to your seat, and a young man can aid you across the street if you're an old woman. So there were tons of things. Yeah.
Okay.
You, sir, in the back.
Hi there. My name's Tom Reck, but you can just call me Reck Tom.
I'm from Down Below Magazine. What, was there any tearing down there?
Well, you see, when one hole exists, and the objective is to increase the tear in one's hole, you must only tear. There is no gentle way to go about it. You pass. There was much, much tearing in this. I think you're a woman. You there!
Hi, yes, I appreciate the question. Cheryl from Women's Health Field. When you ask your wife to make you a sandwich, what do you like to have on it?
Well, there's typically bread and some meat. Cheddar cheese and some pickles too. Yes, there's pickles on the sandwich also. You, shorter man sitting with the blonde hair.
Yes, thank you. My name is John Fiber from Twice a Day Every Day. And my question for you, sir, is before you did this big deal, was your meal unusually large?
When I ate the Subway sandwich that was an entire 8 feet long, and my anus split. I actually had three Subway sandwiches that day. My meal was rather large. You, next to him, sir.
Frank Fisher from Health and Safety Magazine. Were there any concerns by your local health department about doing it where you did it?
Well, I was at the hospital, so... there were no concerns. I was quickly escorted to the ER when my anus split. You, pirate in the red shirt.
Alfonso Dunn, yes. From Fertilizer Week. We are curious to know whether there was any monetary value, I mean, considering.
Because I was in the garden.
That would be perfect, actually.
Yes, because, as you know, shit fertilizes. I actually have not received any royalties yet, but my lawyer is working it out. He's busy holding one hand over the nose. Sir, yes, you.
Yeah, hi, Tom Chertle from Fertilizer Weekly. And I wondered, was it as long as it was wide?
Well, when you're in a petting zoo and you just have to go, you don't really look at what's going on the back end. You kind of stare, but then not really look anywhere at the faces that are in awe as your insides are falling out of your ass. Sir, who loves the light? You.
It's actually, I'm Fanny Flushing from the Bathroom Bible. And I was just wondering, did you have to buy a brand new extra large throne to do your dirty deed?
Well, my throne is considerable in size, all things considered. I did not buy a new throne when I pooped uncontrollably in my bathroom.
Johnny Guinness from Guinness World Magazine. Can you tell me the exact weight of the deed?
Well, when I dropped the world's biggest deuce. It weighed exactly as much as I did because everything inside changed. it was quite an out-of-body experience. ma'am.
Hi, Francine from Franchise Weekly. Do you expect the businesses to host large commodes?
Because I did this at IKEA, they are asking me to now co-sponsor all of their commode commercials and star in them as well. But I think you have a pressing question. Yes.
Yes. Hi, I'm Clarice Colostomy from True Confessions Magazine, and I just wanted to know, when you did you get fries with that?
Well, there were fries all inside of me. I didn't really need any more, but I can understand your affinity for the golden treats. You know, I don't trust McDonald's French fries anymore. They have led me astray many times. Yes, sir, I'm sorry I called you a woman earlier, but yes.
I don't know who you're talking about, mister. This is my first question. My name is Honey Roasted. I'm from Nuts, Nuts, Nuts. And my question to you, sir, is did you leave the peanuts on the table, or did they make you remove them before you did, sir?
I must tell you, you have a fine Southern accent.
Thank you, darling.
You know your way around the toilet the way I do, right?
Bless your heart!
Yeah. My heart was blessed the day that I survived such an accident.
Answer the question!
I was at Texas Roadhouse and the steak just came all out onto the floor. As you can tell, this has happened to me many times in many places. Sir, near the light. Jesus, if I may.
My name is Guy Bunningham V. And from the Fried Frontier. And I was wondering if before this event, did you take advantage of the unlimited choice in toppings available to you?
Unlimited toppings, you say?
Again, that was Guy Bunningham V. Don't forget it.
No. Well, I'll get back to your question, sir, I promise you.
So why don't you answer a real question?
Okay, aggressive interviewer, bring it on.
Yeah, I'm Guy Greasetrap. And me and my four brothers from Sibling Magazine.
Hey, Guy, I see you over there.
Hey. And we just want to know, did you eat everything available to do this incredible deed in this place? My four brothers and I, the five of us in total.
I catch you, Drift. You're not so aggressive.
Hey, where I'm from, this is just saying hello.
You can just be assertive. It would be fine. But when you dine at the Willy Wonka of burgers, you must understand that every guy, all five of them, guys. You must shit like you've never shit before, as I did. I dropped the world's largest, most dynamic cheese juice ever at Five Guys. And now I thank you for coming out to smell and hear about my story. There are stains that will never be removed. And I thank you for your time.
Wait, sir, I need your number!